So, welcome student to our BA third year Indian Writing in English class. So, again in this video, we will discuss the remaining part of our poem, The Professor by Nisim Ezekiel. And this is our lecture 2. Now, see the lines from our poem. Whole world is changing in India also. And we are keeping up. Our progress is progressing. Old values are going. New values are coming. Everything is happening with leaps and bounds. I'm going out rarely now and then. Only this is price of old age. But my health is okay. Usual aches and pains. No diabetes, no blood pressure, no heart attack. And this is because of sound habits in youth. Now in this video, he very beautifully explain about the changing world, about the progress, about the values that are coming, or about the happenings that leaps that which happens. He explained it in third stanza of this poem. Everything is happening with leaps and bounds. So here in a simple words, I want to explain the meaning of this paragraph. So here we can say the professor keeps on talking and talking. He talks about the changing times and the importance of change. Old values are being replaced by new values. He insisted, trying to make him engage in the conversation, though the listeners, or we can say the students, is not replying, that the fellow is not reciprocating. The professor himself only is taking is talking to his students. Now see the next line. I'm going out, the line 22 to lines 22 to 35. I'm going out rarely now and then. Only this is the price of old age. But my health is okay. Usual aches and pains, no diabetes, no blood pressure, no heart attack. This is because of sound habits in you. So see the hard words here. Value here means the importance, worth, or usefulness of something. Leaps here means jump or spring a long way to a great height or with great force. Bound here means walk or run with leaping strides. Rarely here means not often, or we can say seldom. Now now I am giving the explanation of our present line from 22 to 35. Here actually the professor describes his own health. He was just talking about his family, or we can say the three boys, talking about his family, the three boys, then two girls. Now he is coming to the point where he is talking about his own health, and he says his health is okay. Now Nisim Ezekiel has used the word, the term okay, in the way that we usually use it in routine day-to-day conversation. It doesn't look like very much versified, or we can say it doesn't look like poetic one. It looks very much casual. It looks very much routine kind of language to us. But he then mentions that he does have usual aches and pains, though his health is okay, and he has a few aches and pains which is very usual at this age. Then proudly he indicates that he is not suffering from diabetes or blood pressure or any heart disease. That is again a kind of proud feeling to this professor. So in a very simple language, he explains about his condition, about his fitness, or about his strong health. Then he says that he is not suffering from such kind of diseases. The professor feels proud to say that he is healthy because of the good habits that he has cultivated from his youth. Now, he is giving the reason also why he is so fit and why he is not having diabetes or heart attack or any bigger kind of diseases at this age. And he is giving the reason that good habits which he had cultivated in his youth. Definitely, this can be the reason for his good health. Then he talks about the listeners. He asks the listeners the health of that person. Now he is asking till here. The professor is talking. He is mentioning everything about himself only. He was not asking anything to this person, to the listener, to the students. Now he is trying to this fellow, this listener, the students, and he is asking about the health. Now, student, in this slide, you will find the last paragraph of our poem, The Professor by Nisim Ezekiel. And again, this is our lecture 2. Now, see the paragraph. How is your health keeping? Nicely. I am happy for that. This year, I am 69 and hope to score a century. You were so thin like stick. Now, you are man of weight and consequence. This is good joke. If you are coming again this side by chance, visit please my humble residence also. I am living just on opposite house backside. So again, here, the professor finally reveals his age. He says that he is 69. And hopes to live for 100 years. This is again a kind of psychology or mentality of old age people in India, that they love to have 100 plus of age. He jokes with his students that he used to be like a stick earlier, but now he looks like a man of weight and consequence. He remembers that the students before few years was not this much healthy, or he was not having this much of weight. That's why he is jokingly talking that the student that he was looking like a stick, very thin one, very thin one, but now being a man, being a very healthy one, he looks better with a weight and consequences. Then in the last lines, we can say the professor asks him to pay a visit to his home if he ever comes near to his dwelling place. And these last two lines are really, really wonderful. And he says, if you are coming again this side by chance, visit please my humble residence. My humble residence also. He is actually requesting to the student that please visit to his place. And this is a humble request. And he says that my humble residence also. And I am living just on opposite houses. Backside. That is to say that he is just trying to adjust words. He is just trying to use a huge English language. Though he is not good at, and the formation of these sentences is showing something else, and that is actually a form. So in this way, we completed our whole poem, The Professor by Nisim Ezekiel. Thank you.